Hey everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to TechNews episode 252. BSNL is going to roll out its 4G services by a timeline of September 2022. Minister of State for Communications said that there is no proposal under consideration for disinvestment of BSNL and MTNL. Meanwhile, private telcos Airtel, Jio, Vodafone Idea have successfully carried out 5G trials in the metropolitan cities of India. Kindly check out the screen. The mentioned emojis were the most popular emojis of 2021 according to the Unicode Consortium. Google is working on a Pixel Watch and that is expected to hit the market next year. The Pixel Watch will follow a circular design and be devoid of perspectile bezels. The Pixel Watch is likely to run on a Wear OS. The Realme Watch T1 has a bezel-less 1.3-inch circular AMOLED display. This watch was launched in China in October. The wearable offers almost 110 sport mode including badminton, elliptical, hiking and walking and other features as well. Oppo launched the Reno 7 series in China last week. This lineup consists of Reno 7 Software Edition, Vanilla Reno 7 and the Reno 7 Pro and went on sale yesterday. The company said that the interest toward the mid-ranges was so high, the whole first batch sold out in 15 minutes, bringing the revenue of around 100 million Chinese yuan. Every year, Oppo hosts an event to present its latest innovation and technologies, and the time for 2021 conference has come. In a press release, the company announced that it will take place on December 14-15 in Shenzhen. Oppo Pad is being rumored to launch in China very soon. This tablet is said to be powered by a Snapdragon 870 chipset. For those waiting in India, we have learned that Oppo Pad will make its way to the country next year. Oppo F21 Pro Plus and Oppo F21 will launch on the same stage between the March 17th and 21st of 2022. Oppo F21 Pro is also in the works and should tag along later. Oppo F21 series will succeed the Oppo F19 lineup. Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition will launch in India around the same time as a global announcement. This handset will be available in white, black, pink and green color options in the country. Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition key specifications could include a 6.4-inch Full HD Plus display, 64-megapixel primary camera and a 4500mAh battery. Vivo could be working on a phone with an extensible display similar to that on Oppo X 2021 rollable phone. The patent was filed at Vivo back in May 2021 and was published on December 2nd. No hardware specification of the phone have been revealed at this moment. Xiaomi 12, Xiaomi 12X and Xiaomi 12 Pro are expected to debut on December 28th. These flagships will be the first to be powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. Xiaomi 12 series may debut in China first and later expanded to other markets. IQ Neo 6 has been spotted on the Google Play console with the model number V2154A. The key specifications include a Full HD Plus display, 12GB of RAM, Android 11 OS, Snapdragon 888 processor and Adreno 660 GPU. The render shows that the phone has a center position punch hole and a curved edges. A Chinese tech giant Huawei could launch its proprietary operating system for its global users next year. For those unaware, Harmony OS is already available in the company's home market, China. At this moment, over 140 smartphones, tablets, smart screen devices and other features this OS, although the global rollout has to be officially announced. The current version of the Harmony OS has primarily been focused for Chinese users but have already been installed by over 100 million users. Huawei has first unveiled the OS back in 2019 during the Huawei Developer Conference, emphasizing on its cross-platform functionalities. The next PS5 restock date in India is set for Monday on December 6. The PS5 Digital Edition and PS5 will be available to pre-order at 12 PM on Shop at SC, Game the Shop and other retailers. The Sony PS5 starts at ₹39,900 in India. Uber partners with WhatsApp to announce ride booking service via WhatsApp in India. Users can now book rides through Uber's official chatbot on WhatsApp. This service is currently available in Lucknow. Krafton has announced that data transfer from PUBG Mobile to Battleground Mobile India will end soon for players who tried out Livik map in PUBG Mobile. Krafton has requested players to complete the data transfer process as soon as possible. Krafton has not specifically explained why PUBG Mobile data transfer for BGMI is shutting down. Revolt RV400 gets an ₹18,000 price hike and the ex-showroom price now stands at ₹1,25,000. The warranty on the board battery has been reduced from 8 years to 6 years. Revolt RV400 electric bike is currently live for pre-booking. solar eclipse will be available in India on Saturday, December 4, 2021. This will be the second as well as the last solar eclipse of the year 2021. And it will last for 4 hours and 8 minutes, starting at 12:30 PM IST and after reaching its peak at 1 PM IST. The total solar eclipse will be sandwiched between two parallel solar eclipses. The first one will begin at 10:59 AM IST and will last till 12:30 PM IST. And the following one will begin at 1:33 PM IST and end at 1:33 PM IST and end at 3:07 PM IST. Government spent rupees 65 crore on Indian men's hockey team in last 5 years. The government has also shelled out close to rupees 104 crore on 20 infrastructure projects. The senior men's hockey team returned with an historic bronze medal. And the government has said that the money was utilized for coaching camps, competition and other expenses. An amount of rupees 45 crore has been spent on the senior hockey men's team and rupees 20 crore on junior hockey men's team towards coaching camps, foreign competitions, domestic competitions and salary of coaches, equipment, etc. during the last 5 years. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.